I have top five. Shucks. Okay, Michael Jackson.
Okay, let's go.
Michael, Britney Spears.
Yeah. Oh, damn, unexpected.
Yeah. Is it because you got a big crush on Britney Spears?
Yes. Nah, last time. Toxic, is it?
Yeah.
The Toxic?
Yeah. Even before Toxic, like the Oops I Did Again and the Hit Me Baby One Time. Yeah. I'm telling you, Britney Spears last time is a problem. I think.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the one and only Wello Show.
Yeah, do follow us on Spotify. You will be at the Wello Show. We're posting exclusive and so additional content that will not be on YouTube. Check it out, guys.
Yep. Today, we got a very, very special guest with us.
Yes. Yeah.
He is a singer-songwriter, rapper, and also a music producer.
Yes, one of the biggest in the Southeast Asia. Please welcome Alyph.
Let's go. Alyph in the house.
Yeah. Wello. Yeah. How are you?
Wello. How are you guys doing?
Thank you very much for coming here. Yes. Really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah. So okay, let's jump straight to the thing lah, that you just released a new single, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So can you tell us a little bit about the single? What's the meaning behind it? And yeah.
Well, Swipe?
Yes,
like Swipe. The new single. It's just basically knowing what you like and what you don't like. And just being sure of it.
Okay, that one is based on like what?
Life experience,
girls or friends or what?
Because
I think it's like a general thing, you know, as well. Like I feel in my life or rather songs that I write.
Okay.
Sometimes when I make songs, I want to make something that I relate to, again.
Yeah, yeah,
but
yeah.
At the very same time, when you put it out there, the song is no longer for me. It is for the listeners.
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
So if they don't understand my story, then the song won't serve a purpose.
Mm. Okay.
So I think for Swipe specifically, it comes from a background of always trying to do something, and then after that, you will have people around you saying, you know, it's a bad idea or it's a wrong idea or anything, and then sometimes you believe them, sometimes you don't, you know. But over time, you realize that, hey, actually, your intuition, whatever, you know, your ideas are actually like, you
meaningful
know,
and stuff.
And
yeah.
you look back, they have been working more than you've been listening to some other people. So that's what Swipe is about, you know, like sometimes you just got to be sure of yourself. But then again, also, sometimes kita pun syok sendiri, you know, like,
betul.
You know, kita pun fikir macam kita bagus gila or whatever, we want to do our stuff. So there's a fine line between, like, actually having great ideas and jokes sendiri. That's a fine line.
It ends up into a big thing lah. Becomes Swipe the.
Yeah.
Okay, so I want to talk about like your starting of your career. When do you actually feel like, hey, I think I can make music, yeah? You know, like, where do you find the...
That's a good question.
The start. Because you've been doing this for quite a while, at least.
Very long time. Yeah.
More than 10 years, really.
I still don't know when this became a career.
Oh.
Okay.
Yeah, I still feel... Because I came up from the underground hip-hop scene here in Singapore.
Mm-hmm.
But I think coming up like as a young boy, like teenager... You go through phases, right?
So I had many
phases.
Oh.
Also, you know, I had phases where I would lepak. And then I had phases where I would skate.
This guy also skated.
We were talking about it early on.
Yeah.
And then I found music shortly after that.
Yeah.
But I've always been a fan of music. I always loved music. Music was always in my family.
Mm-hmm.
But I think somewhere in secondary school, I think it was Teacher's Day, you know, and after I saw Budak Sek 3, I think they were performing for Teacher's Day.
Okay.
And then they were doing like Dikibarat.
Okay,
Dikibarat.
Ewa Bulan.
I think one of them are, kan. And then dia ada Tukang Karut. So the Tukang Karut started performing and then he started rapping.
Okay.
And then when he started rapping, it reminded me of like the rappers I was listening to at that point. I was listening to Eminem.
Okay.
I was listening to, I think, Tupac and a little bit of Linkin Park.
Okay.
So, and then I just watched Too Fat on TV, Time Raya. So then it almost... Something in me was like, I think I can do better than this guy.
Mm.
I was sec one and I had no background, nothing.
Okay.
So what I did was, I think the following weeks after that, you know, you have the big books where you write. What they are like big notebooks ah, macam
notebook itu
lah. Jotter book
ada line kan.
Legend or what? Jotter book.
Yeah, so Jotter books. Yeah.
Aku pergi cakap drawing blog.
Bulu. Artis.
Yeah, Jotter books. And then I would write rhymes. I would start writing rhymes.
Okay.
And then I would make music in my mind, right? But I don't know how to
deliver it lah.
Deliver, right? So I would like draw lines.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, like lines. I would draw lines.
That is like the shapes. Flow, the flow.
Just for me to remember.
Oh.
So like, for example, in my head, right? So I will like maybe draw tan, and then tan, like that. So every time I go back there, then I'll remember that melody. Like,
That's how you visualize melody, eh?
Yeah, so I visualize first before I started making music. And then I think slowly, my cousin, who is also my best friend, he was in the the hip-hop scene first. So he brought me.
Oh, okay.
Because bila raya jumpa, and then, you know, we'll share. He was a biker at that point of time. Dia budak Ulen juga.
Let's go, Ulen.
So when we met during raya, then we update, like, what are you doing now? Then I'm like, I'm starting to, like, write. And he say, serious? He say, like, I just made some friends with the hip-hop scene here. So he brought me over, jumpa. And I think that started. I think I got Fruity Loops. But it was cracked. Demo version.
Okay.
FL
demo version. They don't pass around a CD.
Oh.
So sendiri I belajar. I think I asked one of my friends how to make music, and then he was like, "This is the beat. Yeah, this is the kick. This is the snare. Ta 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 ta."
You just play around.
And then I was like,
"So in the beginning, it's like, can I say like a struggle?
Yeah.
Tak tahu buat lagu apa macam mana? Like how ah?"
I would say I didn't feel much of it's a struggle though. But now if I think about it, yeah, I was struggling trying to learn then.
Mm-hmm.
But at that point in time, I didn't feel like it was a struggle.
It was fun lah, right?
Yeah. Ultimately also, I wanted to hear the music that I was hearing in my head lah. So I tried to do everything I could do just to make that happen, you see. And I mean, we didn't have FL instructor answers that we can find. I think that was one thing good about not having information last time. So macam like all of us learn how to make music kan. But without information, it's like a natural filter.
You like learn yourself every single
thing.
Yeah,
because maybe you give up, I give up, you give up, and then you don't give up. Right? And then that is realizing that actually you really want to make music.
Yeah.
The rest of us kita ni macam
ikut-ikut
je nak try.
For fun lah gitu.
Yeah, so I think that was one of the good things about not being able to have much information last time. You know, those music producers who really, really tak boleh tidur, just really want to put it out. We will sit at home and just...
But sometimes before you sleep, you have that song in your head, you just want to get it out, and then you just don't go to sleep and then make the beat.
Yeah.
Right.
I just don't even try going to sleep. I just
stray away all the way.
Yeah. The life of especially producing music, right? You don't realize this, but it's a bit different from a performer. So, but performer is like you spend the days practicing and you perform on stage and then you get off and then you have fun, it's done. But for producers, it's a lot of most of the time when you are practicing, nobody's watching. Because you're at home music. It's only for yourself. You really have nothing but yourself and your craft. So that will go into very, very late nights. Like your pattern of sleep will probably be nocturnal lah, basically.
Which one do you start first? Like rapping first or producing? Because I know you produce the show.
Same time.
Oh, the same time?
Same time. So I wanted to make a whole song myself. Like one time. So
then
time.
Like when you were young, right, when you start making music and everything, like you make your music based on like experience or based on like
life experience,
eh? Life experience or based on what people want or which.
Yeah, is for sure. I mean,
or trendy somehow. No?
Well, I would naturally when you start something, right, you are still following the previous reference.
Okay.
Like if you enjoy skating, you know, you will reference like Chet Masker, whoever that you like, and then you follow. And then slowly, years after that, then your own style will develop, right? So, for me, because I listen to, like, for example, Eminem a lot. So, Eminem was a storyteller.
Well, so, his favorite also Eminem.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, not really a diehard of Eminem fan, but I listen to Eminem.
This guy always. Always like he's scared that you ask.
Yeah, I'm scared that you test me about Eminem. I cannot answer.
But true, what? You like Eminem. What? You say one of your favorite artists, Eminem. What? Yeah. Like, can, what?
Please save us, save us.
Always trying to be politically correct. But okay. I would start writing rap songs more of, like, I would have more stories.
Mm-mm.
I'll write about stories like things that I see every day, stories of my friends, because I got a lot of friends.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I know a lot of stories. Okay. And then we're all like girls, so
we
got a lot of girl stories. So a lot of songs.
We'll get to that later.
Yeah, so a lot of songs for like girls also. I think slowly they develop into but also, like, I mean, Tupac, like the rest of the hip hop in its essence is actually documenting, like,
mm-hmm.
rap is documentation. It's about documenting time in history, and
mm-hmm.
you know, it's almost like commentating. Is that a word? Commentating on current events and all mm-hmm. that, you know,
yeah. Like, it's a narration, something like that.
So, like, so rap evolves, and but at the heart of it, that's what. It was.
Okay, then I heard Eminem say that.
Oh, yeah?
Eminem.
Let's go!
I heard that Eminem, correct me if I'm wrong, I heard Eminem say that he used to read dictionary to get better. Then what do you do for yourself, to get better in rapping or what?
I don't know. That's a very good question. But Eminem is he's very technical. He's a genius as well. He naturally has it. But, you know, his love for words, I would say, and rhyming words made him, like, read the dictionary. Maybe where that passion of his is in me is maybe through music. You know, the patience that I have. Like, you want to finish a whole dictionary, you need to have a lot of patience.
True.
Siapa saya nak, you know, like, oh, I'm alone.
Let's read the dictionary.
You know, like, it's not even less, like, I shall read dictionary. So I think that for me is making music. You know, because it's because I know firsthand, like, my friends see, like, why do you even bother? Because I am sitting in front of the computer and like I've never seen anything like this in my life. How do you expect to turn this into some a song, you know, let alone begin? So
other than Eminem, who's your favorite artist? Eminem is like your number one. Is it?
I'm Eminem is one of my top few. I mean, Eminem dulu ah.
Dulu ah.
Dulu
ah. Ha? Eminem dulu ke? Eminem
sekarang. Eminem it's sekarang both.
Kami
both.
Okay. I have many artists that I like. I like
okay, let's see. Top 5.
Top 5, yeah.
Top 5. Let's go. Top 5.
You mentioned Tupac also?
Yeah.
Tupac should be up there.
But these are all just names that of the people I was listening to at that point in time in my life. I have top 5. Shucks. Okay, Michael Jackson.
Okay, let's go.
Michael, Britney Spears.
Damn, unexpected.
Yeah. Is it because you got a big crush on Britney Spears?
Yes. Last time. Toxic, is it?
Yeah.
The Toxic?
Yeah, even before Toxic, like the Oops, I Did It Again and the Hit Me Baby One Time. Yeah. I'm telling you, Britney Spears last time is a problem. I think. I love
Michael Jackson, Britney Spears,
Eminem.
Eminem three.
He's my backbone. I would say
R. Kelly, Tiba.
R. Kelly, Tiba.
R. Kelly, Rayhan. Backstreet Boys.
Okay.
Nice.
4 Backstreet Boys.
And
last one.
Yes. Let's see. Last one.
Rihanna, Beyonce, no.
Okay, a bit later.
Like
Chris Brown, I say.
Chris Brown. Nice. Kanye, you don't like Kanye?
Oh my God! Okay,
Kanye,
Kanye.
Kanye, that's why.
Kanye. But Kanye now problematic a bit,
Yeah, he's just very rude now.
Political, already.
Yeah, he's just very rude.
Then previously we got this COVID and everything. Like, how does it feel to finally get to perform? You know,
after a long time.
After a long time,
really good, yeah. right before COVID, I actually was about to take like a 1 year break for myself,
mm-hmm.
just to spend more time in one place mm-hmm. instead of traveling okay. all the time, because I travel every other week.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
So, but after COVID, but during COVID, I was like, I think very long that I've been in one place. So, when the shows first started, I didn't really wait. I was like, I think I went to KL and there was a show going on. And then I just told the organizer, I was like, can I just go on stage yeah. and do one song? The organizer
was like a relief.
Yeah. The organizer was like, yeah, go.
Go and actually, can I know what's the difference between fan in Malaysia and in Singapore? What's the difference? Obviously, there's a difference, right?
Yeah, a little
confirm
bit.
Malaysia one, confirm more
sikit
crazy.
Sikit. I think because Singapore is small, you see. Mm, Singapore yeah. is like much LA. So macam like everybody knows each other one way or another.
Yeah, correct,
you
know, correct, true. Yeah, yeah.
Kalau jauh pun like cousins friend.
Yeah, 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 yeah,
you know. So and Singapore there's a higher chance of bumping into
each other.
Each mm-hmm. other. So I guess that's where it becomes.
So dia punya fan feeling is not really like, because you most so of the time you will bump into each other. So like yeah, Malaysia is sure. big, so you won't really see. They won't really see you.
Yeah.
So when they see you, it's like
gila, yeah.
right?
Mm. Yeah, like if you're from macam Kuantan, for example,
mm-hmm.
and then you know I will go to Kuantan, you know, and visit for like maybe press or if I have a show or something like that. But other than that, you know, I might not be hanging
yeah,
around
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So, you know, so I guess that's where you feel the appreciation
mm-hmm.
you know,
mm-hmm.
of somebody who listens to your music at
yeah.
its
yeah,
fullest.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But I will not discount, you know, fans in Singapore who do appreciate me also, you know,
yeah,
because
yeah.
like some of them who actually really listen to my music and also whatever, you know, if they see me also, you know, they'll, you know, we show love.
Yeah. yeah. You also produce beats for other artists in Singapore as well and Malaysia.
Yeah.
I would say somehow that you are really good. I would kind of say that you are like the Pharrell of this region.
Let's go.
Can you accept that?
Can I accept that? I was
yeah.
Is that a compliment?
It is.
Now I accept it.
I just want to ask that. It takes a lot of this. I don't really believe in talent. Like, born talent. I don't believe in that.
Really?
Yeah. I believe in practice.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you don't believe that?
I don't believe that people are born with talent that straight away they can do.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I believe
I kind of agree with Achab actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel that.
So everyone starts the same?
They have a bit of ups and downs. Like, this guy maybe have this kind of privilege more.
Mm.
Yeah. So
I low-key disagrees, yeah. But you carry on.
Let's say you don't have a computer, you cannot make beats, right?
Okay.
Yeah. So the people who have the applications, like the richer family, they can make beats. And the one who's poorer cannot really make. That's why I feel that if you are putting them in the same level, right? Then they go up together, right?
Yeah.
It's like, it's kind of similar, lah. It depends on the hard work.
But you are talking about circumstance,
Yeah.
You know, that's not really talking about talent,
Is it? Then
you know,
is
because
talent.
You can have a lawyer who can sing really well.
Correct.
But I feel that somehow they are practicing, maybe in the shower.
What the hell?
Maybe. Who knows? It's like they cannot be the first song they sing is the best.
Okay, now I want to ask you. Right now, like, let's say if I can sing, like, you cannot sing, like, it's just because I can sing, what? It's not because I practice, what? Like, to a certain extent.
You are practicing at home. That's what I feel and believe.
Some people just cannot sing, you know. Even though if they practice,
like,
they
don't wanna, they don't want to learn it somehow. Right? You think about it, like,
nah. Some people are really tone deaf. Like,
yeah, just cannot.
Is it really?
Like tone
but
deaf.
You can learn all those things. Right? Just that's why they.
How many
really.
Like how many auditions you see on American Idol? They say my
to
vocal,
me that
my
one
vocal
right.
coach. Oh, I mean,
their practice is lesser, lah.
Yeah. But nah, dude. I think
you
I
believe
think,
in.
I think you.
It's talent plus practice lah.
It's a gift.
Yeah, correct.
You know, tapi macam different. Lain orang dapat lain gift lah.
Correct.
Know, like some people have a gift in like numbers.
Yeah.
You know they can just calculate. Like
correct,
you
correct.
Give them numbers, they can calculate for you. Some people can sing. Some people are good at macam you know.
Drawing whatever.
Like you know like what was macam hard macam labor like plumbing and you know those people macam member yang macam I don't know this guy dia macam. I don't know why he doesn't learn how to fix a car, but somehow or other he can know his way around.
Yeah.
Like, only battery, you know, like some of them, I'm like,
yeah,
I have no clue, you know what I mean?
Right.
So maybe I would, okay, well, let's compromise. Maybe I would say that everyone is born with something. Mm. Everyone is born with a talent. But they all have different frequencies
of
talent. So maybe if your talent is higher, you know, and they practice more, and your talent is lower, you practice more. Mm. You know what I mean? So it's probably just frequencies.
So would you say you now, is it based on talent or practice?
Why is it? Wow. Mm. Then segway.
Segway, yeah.
See lah.
A gift, obviously it's a gift, what?
No, like to him.
I feel like it's a gift.
I think it's a gift. I think it's talent. I think practice came with... I think practice for me, right, is like shows. Mm-hmm. They all become practice for me now.
Correct.
Actually being at home, just making music, but no direction. Mm-hmm. Just making music. Just beats and all that, that's practice as well.
And I feel like
the bulk of it is talent.
Okay, I feel like about, like you say about talent also, right? You feel like, you see, like in football, some people got talent, but they are lazy to train, you know? Mm. And then the people who, like let's say you say less talented, right? Then they train more, right? Then they will get better than the one that is talented. What? Yeah. You know what I mean?
I understand.
But saya belum puas dengan the previous point.
Pasal dia masih tak faham.
Aku faham. I can like accept lah. It's like the frequency, I believe in that also lah. Now I understand already lah.
Okay. We coming to an end for the part one lah. Can you describe Alyph, right, in three words? Three words.
Describe myself in three words.
Yeah. For the audience to kenal.
Have you ever described yourselves in three words?
I have actually.
Okay, yeah. What are your three?
Genuine, honest, and humble.
Genuine and honest is like the same thing. Fuck.
Like really honest ni orang. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Macam tadi aku honest dengan kau pasal baju aku semua.
Tapi sekarang tak nak cakap lah. Okay. Well.
Okay, first is talent lah. Let's go lah.
Talented.
No. I think I am
need to think long and hard, this one.
Yeah, because I don't, you know.
Okay, we go back to that later.
Okay, thank you.
Which one do you like more? Producing or rapping?
I like thanks. Yeah. I like shit, I was asked this question also recently before. And then I said I like rap producing, so I like both. But right now, I like performing,
rapping.
Only because I've been just producing for the last 2 years.
Then the latest music, the Swipe, right?
Yeah.
Will there be a music video?
Yeah, a music video is coming up, 28th. But I don't know when you're gonna put this up.
I think 30th we're gonna post this around there.
Maybe? Next week on Sunday. 30th,
then the video will be out already. It'll be out on the 28th of October. So there's
okay. Lastly, do you have any advice for the upcoming artists? Dr. Camera. Advice
for upcoming artists.
Yeah. Young artists. You mentioned just now young artists also.
Yeah?
Yeah. I did. You mentioned that there's a lot of young artists.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So what are the advices that you are willing to give them?
Alyph dengan tu, Alyph.
I think you have to spend a lot of time with yourself. That's number one. You have to spend a lot of time with yourself and your talent and your gift. You know, you gotta develop something first on your own before you want to share it with anybody else. You know, so it's like. When you make music, you contribute, right? For example, we're talking music. So when you make music, you contribute. But if you don't have substance that you created for yourself, you won't be able to contribute.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So I think it's very important to be a little bit individualistic spend time with you and create your own worth, your own value. And then you can go out there and
showcase everything.
All
right. Okay. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Yep. We go to part two. If you guys haven't checked out his latest single Swipe, you guys go and check it out.
Yep.
It will be on all platform, right? Spotify, YouTube.
Yes, sir.
Yep.
And
Apple Music also.
Kalau korang like, korang like. Kalau tak, korang swipe.
Yes. Alright guys, thank you guys. Korang boleh pergi. Baby, aku ada type. Kalau aku like, aku like. Kalau tak, aku swipe. Swipe. Aku ada type. Tak kisah hype ke tak hype. Kalau aku like, aku like. Kalau tak, aku swipe. Swipe. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the one and only Wello Show.
Yeah, do follow us on Spotify. You'll be at the Wello Show. We're posting exclusive and so additional content that will not be on YouTube. Check it out, guys. Let's go.
Yep, still we are here? Still here. Joined with Alyph.
Hello.
Let's go.
Okay, so I want to ask you about this. Before you put out your music, like, who do you usually go to for affirmation before you put out the music? Like, okay, like, let them listen whether, like, this song is good or not.
Good question.
You know?
The person that you trust.
You should teach, like, some of the media how to ask questions. Before I put out music, who do I go to? Okay, I have a list of people, like, about 3 to 4 of my friends that I will let listen to the music.
Okay. Your close friends?
My close friends. Because my closest friends, like my boys, they are not in the business.
Oh, okay.
They almost don't care about my...
So they will be like honest.
Genuine.
Yeah, so we all have different jobs, you know. When we meet up, we talk about everything else. So, 3 or 4 of them, they have... I think... one of them listens to like rock, like punk rock, and then there's another one that listens to experimental,
okay,
like stuff, and then you have another one that is like G-Wang. And then you have another one that is like pure radio.
That means
they just listen to talk.
Hits, like all the hits.
So whatever the radio plays, that's what the person enjoys. So usually I will send it around to them.
Okay.
And then to see what they say.
Well, but like all different categories.
Yeah.
Semua lain-lain.
Which is good. So different opinion of from different kind of genre of music.
Yeah. I don't remember, no? So remember they will say it like it is.
Yeah.
You know, because you know when you're real friends. You know, you will get offended. You won't get offended. If you get offended, also it's like, it's not a grudge.
Yeah.
Pasal kawan. I know you. You know me. So
you know the intention.
So it's like fuck you.
Okay. let's say if they don't like it, right? They say, okay, you need to improve this and that. I don't really like this part. Will you change it or will you just still release
like,
it?
Kau tak tahu lah.
Change it lah. Sometimes the gila. Sometimes macam like
this is my new. This is my.
Sometimes
thing.
The gila macam like.
I don't know that. Like,
nothing, you know, but sometimes also I get very insecure. Then I'll go back and I change. I have this song called Buat Selamanya that I released in 2018. I have like maybe 6 different versions of that song.
Because of the friends.
Because of those idiots.
But is it worth it or not?
No.
Oh, that's
means,
right.
No. I think in the end it was pretty worth it. Because all their stuff made me do all these different versions, which ultimately made me like, oh, okay, I think I put here, I put this there, and then I got the final one. And then the final one was like, I don't need to let anyone listen to this anymore, I'm done. So sometimes it's good when you have no ideas or whatever, and then you throw it around to these people, and then sometimes they give you very unhelpful advice or whatever. But this unhelpful advice will give you inspiration to continue building on it, you know. So
like 6 different versions. One is rock.
No.
All follow.
Something like that. The most annoying thing is these 6 different versions. To me, they all sound very different. But then when I let them hear, don't macam sama je.
Oh, that one irritating.
Macam sama je. Sound like, tak. Ini lain. You know, but yeah, I mean, I cannot help it lah. You know, they are who they are. Right? Kalau dengar sama, that means, if I put it out, so highly likely people won't be able to tell the difference.
Yeah, then, have you ever tried acting or not? Is it?
I did earlier on. Because it's a Singapore thing, you see. When you make music, when you are a performer, And then let's say you gain a bit of traction, a few people, more people come to your shows, want to see you perform, and then they like seeing you perform. And then naturally, the next step is to see how you can expand that. So production houses will come and say, you know, hey, you know, do you want to act? You know, but maybe with you in the show, you know, your listeners can also tune in, and you can also explore a different ability. You know. So I tried it, you know, earlier on in my career, very early on in my career. But then I realized, like, it's to me personally, you know, it's not to anybody else, but to me, I felt like it's like a death trap.
How is it so?
Because once you start, and let's say you enjoy it, and then you want to do more, and then after that, it leads into hosting pula. And then it leads into being an ambassador, being into many things, and then it takes you further and further away from the real thing that you came there to do, which was music.
But this, all of this, like, you can control or you cannot control. It's just the journey of the.
Like I said, that's why just for me personally, because I feel macam if I realize I enjoy it, then I'm afraid it might take me away. Some people can be disciplined and go back to it. But I still feel like if you are a soccer player, you want to be the best, you got to just play soccer.
Understand.
Well, quite interesting, say, when you say like that you are afraid of the things that you enjoy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay. So,
be sure what you like and what you... and you got to be sure what you really like and...
Maybe because he got his end goal, but you want to stick with the end goal. Maybe this is just a side quest, and he enjoy his side quest. That's why, you know? Maybe lah.
But yeah, but I gotta be honest, like to stick to one thing is a very boring process.
Understand. You
know? But to be really good at it, you know, you have no other choice. You have to, like you say, practice and
need to be obsessed with it.
You have to be obsessed with it. You have to.
Okay, then what is your weirdest, right? Girls, fangirl experience.
That was a straight jump from the previous question.
Weirdest.
Good fan experience. Well, I don't want to say it. Let's go. Think of stuff that I can say.
Oh shit.
Think of the stuff that you can put in the next song.
Good, I appreciate it. See, I love it. but maybe it's, maybe stalking is a bit too much. Like stalking.
You stalking or cannot stop?
But this is before social media.
Oh, is it? Then how is it like that?
Yeah. So before social media, you can feel it a bit lah, because then, you know, you might get, you know, letters, or you might realize that the person wants to be close to people who you know. They might do some weird stuff. But with social media, this whole talking thing is gone already. Because anybody can do it.
Exactly. Sir.
We can all stop. Like,
it's actually bad, right?
It just made it acceptable. Social media.
Is it true? Yeah. With these fake accounts and everything.
Yeah. You know, it's become acceptable now. Damn.
Yeah, this guy, like, champion of stalking people. He got a lot of fake accounts, stalking girls.
I see.
Share us a little bit about your stalking career.
How is it going for you? Okay. How is it going for your dating?
What you want to say?
No, like, since you say nowadays it's like social media, so what kind of DMs, weird DMs you got from girls or what?
You want to see?
I don't open...
Oh, you don't open?
I try my best not to open.
No, they all looking like, alamak, Alyph tak open eh. Boring pun Alyph.
I do sometimes, you know. But for the most part, I try not to. You can get lost, macam, you know.
Okay, then during your dating time, right? You got any dating experience, like dating worst experience, not weird experience or what?
Dating? Well, dating kan, I've always... preferred girls that I had to chase.
Okay.
Like, I like the chase. So, I mean, not to be like mean or anything, but macam kalau if it was easy or if it was
boring.
Yeah, mutual. Yeah, I would be less yeah, less interested.
Yeah, I agree with you, sir. But Aslam and Acap difference, yeah.
Aslam, yeah. I want to chase, yeah.
Tiba Aslam and Acap different. The fuck you said,
yeah. We got talk about this before, what? What you say that you prefer that the girl chase you more than you chase the girl, what? Correct, right?
Okay lah, you got a point actually. Yeah. Okay, cannot be that easy also lah. It will be a turn off, right? Correct, right? Correct, okay. Betul lah.
Really? I don't know. I mean, that's you. You might find it flattering, right?
That, I mean, like, okay, you know, I want the chase also lah. But at the same time also, I don't mind the girl chasing me also. But don't be too easy lah. I want a little bit of chase also. You understand not, Ikel?
I understand.
Yeah. Okay, but it's not like totally like fucking this guy. I know him to chase.
Tukar cerita apa?
Tukar cerita. Loki ada tukar sikit. Okay, but you feel like you want the girl to like you more than you liking the girl, right? Like chase you more than you chase the girl, right? Correct, what?
In a way, yeah.
Mm, there you go.
In a way. But not that easy lah.
Achap, you feel the same also, right?
I feel like I want the better girl.
Achap, true, lain.
Lain, ni dah lain.
Lain.
I want the better girl. What do you mean? I want the better girl.
I don't want how to say Loki is the chase also, Loki lah. But I want someone that is good. So if I am already good and then like same level, I okay. You get what I mean?
Yeah.
I need to be big lah.
Difference ada question.
Lain pun ini.
Yeah, I'm trying
to. Tak faham.
Telling ke?
Sial lah. So you what do you think about asking dengan dia punya opinion? Which one do you go with?
That's easier.
Easier. But so aku feel that actually Aslam,
right? Yeah, but why?
But aku wouldn't go. Macam malas lah pada aku.
No, the answer is the question is why you malas why you feel that way?
Why I feel that way?
Oh, you lazy to chase? Is it?
It's like
you don't put in effort.
Like cause apa sih? Like I need to chase you for what? You get what I mean?
Okay.
But if that's your dream girl, don't you want to chase?
Yeah. Ada it focus on other things lah, girl.
So you don't understand the concept of like a dream girl, no?
Not say I don't believe. I believe that some people have. Yeah. Just that I don't want the like. Chase
their bad experiences chasing. That's why.
True.
True.
Right. Yeah, maybe. Aku
true. True.
Yeah. So after a while, you're like, you know,
it's not worth it.
Achap always feel like. When he sees a certain girl, right? Mm. When people like, when you look at a girl and you feel like, hey, this girl, like, damn hot, yeah. Like, I really want to chase this girl. Like, he will always use his mind, like, to like, change to.
Shut it off.
Yeah. And like, this girl, like, how do you do
it's
it?
Like,
then?
Okay, what you mean?
So you psycho yourself.
Yeah,
no, psycho like yourself. I believe that girl, right? Okay, no disrespect to the guy. I don't feel like the girl is way better than anyone else in the world.
There's no doubt that the girl is way better. Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, so I don't have to chase just that girl in my life. Like that's not supposed to be my focus.
So like, what makes me think that she is?
Mm. Yeah. What if I go? I go, then I get right. Then she will break my heart. Then it's like, why chase also? Then I get another dream girl.
Confirm
like,
based on past experience.
Confirm. Of course.
Yeah. Thinking too much. Because you are.
Of course.
Because you're creating stories that haven't happened yet.
Yeah, I know. Right. Understand. Yeah.
Damn,
yeah, but it's my mindset now, like, so it doesn't matter.
but it's a common thing that I hear now also, you know.
Yeah.
People who are afraid to be let down.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's quite a common thing these days. Mm-hmm. Because you guys I wouldn't say, I mean, it helps to build resilience, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It helps to go and not get it many, many times. Mm-hmm. Up to a point where you feel like it hurts you less and less and less.
Yeah.
You know, so you get less let down with every time it happens. I'm not saying that it's going to happen every time.
Yeah, I know.
You know what I mean? But that's life, right? You know what I mean? We're supposed to, you know, just get out there and, you know, do it, you know. But, I mean, to each its own, you know, if you feel that way, you know. But if you sit down and you hope for money to come in also, it won't come.
Exactly,
you gotta get out there and go for a job interview and
job interview.
You feel me? Even if the boss might fire you the next week.
Understand. Yeah. So the boss is like the father like that.
Yeah, I know the boss is like this girl. This you're talking girl. About
dream girl.
Yeah, dream girl.
So go get the girl.
Go get
the girl.
Yeah, don't stop breaking his heart. Basically, you stop breaking their heart.
Tiba aku kena.
Dua-dua dong sama. Mamak ni macam okay lah. Aku say dia so far okay lah.
That's why okay lah.
Alamak.
Correct lah. I feel the
same. Yelah.
Like it's a turn off sir, for me.
No, maybe to Acap is like, if you keep on chasing, it's exhausting lah. It's tiring lah. That's why. Yeah. There are levels to it lah. Don't be too fucking sim that you chase and chase. End up, you took an L. Fucking L.
Mm. Why must spoil me L? You see? Now we same side, now you want to bring me down.
I'm trying to push to like straight. Yeah,
that's why. L. He like that, no? L.
Okay, if you were to meet your 15-year-old self, right? What advice would you give? Or what would you say to that guy?
Just keep doing what you're doing.
Just keep on going. You're doing good.
Okay. Yeah.
So you good?
Just worry less. Just keep doing what you're doing.
In the meantime, what keeps you going in life right now?
What keeps me? Family.
Keep you.
Family. Family gives me a very, very big purpose. I'm a big family guy.
Understand.
I love family. And also being able to reach people with music.
Mm.
I think these two things are. Which I'm, like when I make a song and then I imagine when people are listening to it, how they feel.
Mm.
I think that's one of the things I live for also.
Would you consider other artists in Singapore or Malaysia as your family, the ones who are close to you also, like artists, making music? Artists, the one who you work with lah?
None.
No.
They're all friends.
Okay.
Like acquaintances or... I mean, we say fam, like,
yeah,
you know,
that's right.
But who I really like, would take a bullet for, they don't make music, I think.
Okay. I want to talk about like the song Mimpi.
Or at least not anymore.
Okay.
Sorry, yeah.
Okay. I want to talk about the song that you made with K-Click Mimpi. How do you get to make music with them? Yeah?
Well, they were huge in the underground scene at the time. They were coming up.
Okay.
And they were doing everything themselves.
Mm.
I was about to start this record label. And we were looking for signees and we were looking for songs. So I saw them and then aku macam tak puas sebab the media market has not noticed them yet.
Yeah.
Like the big corporations and the celebrities and all that, they still don't know who they are yet.
They
might have heard sikit-sikit, but they were huge, like with the listeners, with the audience and everything. So I felt like I wanted to do that duty of making a song for them which would propel them into mainstream success, and then inshallah, you know, when they work hard and whatever, then they can take it from there. You know, so when I did that, and then I felt like, okay, my job is done. So
then when you release the song Mimpi, right, do you know that song gonna be a hit or not? Like when you finally get to see like, hey, wow, this song really hits, really flies. How do you feel?
Do you let your other friends that one know, listen to the song?
They all know.
They all know.
I do that at the time. They all were running on a deadline. Well, as for any of my songs, I will have this quiet voice inside me that's saying, like, maybe. You know, but I'm never as confident as my peers, like in the industry. You know, like the K-Click boys, they were very excited, you know. They were like,
this is it.
Confirm.
This,
like,
is the one.
Know? Yeah, and I respect that a lot, you know, because, you know, confidence is key also in the industry, you know. And a lot of my friends are also very confident about the music and how it's going to pan out. But I've always been a bit reserved when it comes to whether a song will happen or not. But regardless, I will still have that small voice inside of me, that hope, lah, you know, of maybe. Yeah.
Then... When it really hit, right, how do you feel, sir? Because that song really, like, wow.
Yeah, how does it feel to, like, millions of people know your work?
Yeah, it's really gratifying. Is that the word, gratifying?
Is it?
Like,
ada.
I feel very grateful. But I don't get excited now, you know?
You don't get excited?
What?
No. I mean, I get very, I think it's more of like, macam, like, just to acknowledge, like macam, wow, it's so great, like, you know, like syukur and all this.
Thankful,
Yeah, thankful. But I don't get overly excited. I don't celebrate it anymore. I think I stopped celebrating it for the past, like, maybe 6-7 years already. So when something goes well or whatever, I stay calm and I just feel good for a while. And then I will brag like fuck, but only to my family. Because, you know, we always say, which I'm like, oh, family again. Okay, I can see this, right?
All out the family.
So all out again. then you know, like, it's love, right? And then once that is over, and then it's straight back to
work.
Always, because I always believe that because this world, we take so much. Mm-hmm. We take so much. We take, we buy coffee, people make for us.
Mm.
Food, people cook for us.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, you take the bus, somebody drive the bus for you, We don't give,
Yeah.
We take away. So like, when I make music, to me it's like I'm trying to give something back.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So when something goes well, for instance, like Mimpi, my main intention was to hope that I can bring K-Click into the mainstream media smoothly, to get smoothly. And when I saw that, I was like, okay, that's gonna happen. Now I'm good. Now I can move to my next thing.
Do you feel afraid that you won't be relevant, or how do you stay relevant? You get what I mean?
In the music industry.
I get what you mean.
Yeah.
But I don't feel
you don't have that thought.
Like pressure of fuck, I need to be relevant. Nah, I need to do this and that.
I don't think
fuck, then how am I gonna do it? Macam gitu.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever felt that pressure.
I see.
I certainly hope not. But I've never thought about it, I just did my thing.
That's good.
And if this is what I'm supposed to do, then everything will work itself out.
True.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, right.
I think if this question of relevance thing has been very misunderstood with promoting yourself. I think promoting yourself is actually mainly how you stay relevant, but what you do needs to always be the same. No matter what happens or whatever, you still need, if you're a painter, you don't need to paint when you mix painting with promoting the painting, then you will think of ways to make this painting relevant,
you know what I mean.
But if you're a painter, you just paint. Just paint. And if it's good, it's gonna sell itself.
Yeah.
It's gonna be relevant by itself, you see.
There is like an unnecessary thought,
Unnecessary
pressure also.
Yeah.
You just gotta do your thing and trust.
Listen, Ajab.
But is it?
It applies to girls as well, Ajab.
Maybe.
Unnecessary thoughts all buang, Ajab.
I go paint.
But it's the days of social media and technology.
I feel like social media also now fast paced. I want more. Please deliver more.
That's why people feel the pressure to be relevant, right?
Yeah.
When in actual fact, relevance is something that just happens when you're doing the right thing.
Correct.
It's not something you have to focus on.
Correct.
You don't focus on relevance. You focus on.
Yeah, it's true.
And the relevance will come. Like money, I don't want to go so deep inside also because I might be wrong. You know what I mean? Even for money also. You see people who are very passionate in what they do
or any job, trying to get money.
Yeah, and then they have a family to feed and all that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have family and all. They're children and all. They're fine, they're happy, you know what I mean? And then you compare to somebody who is like looking for money constantly. Mm-hmm. That search is very tiring in comparison to the person who has less but is like enjoying. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I agree.
Yeah, correct. I think relevance is the same thing.
People say that when you become a dad, you really change from your behavior or your point of view towards life. It's true, is it?
You think so?
I don't know.
A lot of people say that.
A lot of people say that. I don't know.
Feel that you change?
And sometimes also I can see that they change also.
More responsible, is it?
Yeah,
they are more not hot temper,
more fun,
laid back, more understanding, macam gitu. That's what I
think
observe.
I think maybe you're right in a sense whereby you realize that you are not the most important person on earth anymore.
The girl I want to chase that one.
Yes.
Masih nak bring back the girl.
Yes. Macam, right? Because you are the most important, right?
Yeah,
that's why she has to come to you. You know, who do you think you was? So maybe you should adopt a child first.
Maybe.
Oh, damn.
Then maybe the girl will come.
Okay lah.
Okay, what is your end goal in life? Last few questions.
Yeah.
We're going deep with the last few questions.
Fuck.
Like when you do this, you feel like, you know what? I've done it. At least I've done it. Like that.
Like Thanos. Sibling.
Kau nak bawa Marvel eh? Marvel banyak kat sini tau.
What's the...
What is your end goal in life?
My end goal in life. My end goal in life is...
Nobody asked you this question before.
To... No. No, that's why I say. You guys need to give some of these questions, huh? Shake Bayamun. <Bayamun. laughs> Well, it is to pass on myself through my family, you know, and to know that I've done something that would live on after I'm
generation.
Gone.
Legacy.
A legacy, you know, whether it be music, whether it's through my kids or whatever, but yeah, to leave a footprint behind.
Would you want your kids to follow your career or make music?
It's up to them. I wouldn't recommend, I wouldn't suggest, but if they want to, then I will support. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I understand.
I wouldn't give them the idea like, hey, you wanna.
But they can see you working at home also. I think they
do, they show signs really. Yeah.
You have the idea already.
They show signs really, but yeah, I cannot help it.
All right, Aslam, any last question?
Okay, I want to ask you, like, some people say, right, you have to be consistent in what you do and put in the hard work, right? But some people apply that, but they still cannot get the outcome that they want. So what advice would you give, right, to them? Because they are doing the right thing, you know? You get what I mean? Like, put in the hard work, be consistent, but the outcome is still, like, it's not up there.
I understand.
Then how, like, this person, like, don't know what to do, really. Like, I've done what I'm supposed to be, doing, right? But
nothing.
The outcome, nothing happened. Like, so now they are confused. Don't know what to do now.
Yeah. Well, 9 times out of 10, you gotta check your niat. That one is already a case of your intentions.
Intentions.
Yeah. That one, like 9 times out of 10, highly likely is already your intentions. Mm. Because like, you want something, but why you want that something? Why am I working so hard to want that something?
Okay.
You know.
Yeah.
Like, some people want to become like the naik pangkat dalam kerja or whatever, right? They want a boss to give them a promotion or whatever. You know, why? You know, some people, they want it because they know that if they see, I know what I'm going to do when I'm at that position. I can see how I can make this whole place better. You know what I mean? And then you have somebody else who's working hard to get there, but they want there because so during Hari Raya or Chinese New Year, what they can say to their, I'm now the second CEO of the company. You know what I mean? Or like, I want to buy that big car so I can stunt on my previous company who fired me. You know what I mean? So really, this is a question of your intentions, really. And 9 times out of 10, right, we don't do this. And we cannot help ourselves also, you know?
True.
We cannot help ourselves. Like, if it's for those type of reasons to prove somebody wrong or whatever, and then we can't get it right. Most of the time, we don't want to admit something like that. And then we don't understand why people get it. Because when the people get it, and then they do something about it, and then kita tengok, kita macam like, hari ni buat macam tu, dah boleh. Macam kat sini, macam
work
my ass off.
Sometimes I feel that way also.
Because that person's intentions are might be way more purer than yours, and way more selfless than yours.
Actually, that's a really good advice.
I can take it. The advice
for the girl?
No. Hey, she can also.
Macam sekarang ni apa masalah kau dengan the girl? You talk to the camera now.
Apa nama dia sekarang?
Tak boleh bilang.
Just go and chase the girl lah. Please.
Must have good intention first.
That's a damn good question, bro.
Maksud aku kan ada that feeling juga. Tiba tak macam pernah. Confirm we all have that feeling before. Betul lah.
Macam
in school
aku,
or whatever,
aku put in effort, hard work, tapi the progression okay. Outcome ni so
the intention.
I saw a lot of groups in history, right? Performing groups, a lot of them break up. Because you have how many intentions.
Exactly.
Inside one group.
Correct.
And I feel like after you don't get what you want, and you die need to change your goals now,
your intention.
Your intention or your goals now to a different new thing. Start all over again. Yeah. But with good intention, yeah, correct. Yeah,
yes,
yes. Betul lah.
Yeah. Good, yeah. Good. I mean, yeah, intentions that suit you lah. Mm, you know? Yeah, because not everyone is made for the same thing. You see, like I say, we all want this one thing. Like we all want this MacBook because, like, you know, it's nice and all that. Yeah. You know, but if we can accept that, hey, actually, I'm a more this other laptop kind of person. You know, I'll be as equally as happy as you are. You know, but if I cannot see it, I cannot terima.
Yeah.
For as long as I don't get this, I'll be unhappy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know?
I totally understand. This is very good advice, yeah.
All right, guys. There you have it, guys. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Hope you like, comment, and subscribe. And if you guys want to follow us on Spotify, you will be at The Wello Show. And also, if you guys want to follow us on Instagram, it's also at The Wello Show. And thank you very much, Alyph,
for joining us.
Thank we really you. Appreciate it. And lastly, you want to shout out your socials?
Socials.
Alyph Len. Follow me up. Listen to Swipe.
Peace.
Yeah. Alright, guys. Peace. Korang boleh pergi. Baby, aku ada type. Kalau aku like, kalau tak aku swipe. Swipe. Aku ada type. Tak kisah hype ke tak hype. Kalau aku like, kalau tak aku swipe.